Long Notch is well stocked, as you asked.
And our scouts are watching for more Frostclaws.
Our numbers rise. 3 more hunters have passed their trials. But our purpose was to take back the mountain. Now what?
Stay prepared. Sharpen your spears. Should we not return, defending the cut falls to you. If our chieftain agrees with this course.
Sounds like good advice, but let's hope it doesn't come to that.
Chieftain?
The weight of command is no small burden.
I can see that. I take it you haven't spoken to Araya yet?
Why should I? This is what she wanted, to return to Thunder's Drum. It is her only care. So I should have known she would find a way to push aside my spear. After the Karja took my sister, not all of her came back.
What happened to Araya when she was a captive of the Karja?
As a shaman, she's adept with machines, tracking them, stunning them. The Karja used her to capture them for the Sunring, where they were unleashed upon the innocent. They made her part of their blood sport. The shame she suffered beneath their pitiless sun.
She survived.
She endured. Endured by reminding herself of the spirit, her purpose. But now that's all she has.
Tell me what happened to the first expedition.
Araya led the way to the summit, but it was blocked by a great door, some kind of cauldron, new metal. We tried to break through, but it was unflinching. We were exhausted. No way forward and machines behind. I made the call to push back. It cost us greatly. But to remain would have cost us everything. I had hoped to never subject Araya to that again.
What do you think is beyond that door?
I do not know. That expanse of metal, that dead hum. Nothing sacred belongs there. Machines and death, that's what the mountain holds. Death for us, or for the daemon.
And if we do find the spirit?
Then perhaps we should put it out of its misery.
For what it's worth, I'm glad you're coming with me.
Someone has to keep Araya safe.
Good to see you.
Aloy, this is it. My chance to reunite with the spirit, and perhaps to reunite her with the blue light. It's not a chance I would have had alone. I needed an outsider. Someone ignorant of our ways, but... No, not ignorant. I...
Are you trying to thank me, Araya?
Yes, of course. That's what you do. Untangle knots. Create possibilities. Thank you for making this pilgrimage possible. I only wish it had not been necessary to humiliate Aratak. You were wise to let him come. He's earned the right. Stubborn as stone, but he's had to be. The war demanded it. And so have I.
Aratak told me you were a captive of the Karja for a long time. It sounded bad.
For Aratak, it all comes back to that. He thinks the Karja changed me. They did not. They merely sharpened my focus. When all else is lost, you think about what's truly important. The spirit. The blue light. The beyond. And my brother, too. Every time I felt the chill northern wind, I thought of him, worried for him.
What did the war do to Aratak?
He cut away everything, until only his true self remained. Unyielding ice. Nobunuk has more sheer will. He fought the Karja for 1,000 freezing nights, yet always rallied his hunters at sunrise. It is said he endured 23 wounds in those years. His hunters counted them. He never complains of one. Instead, he complains that life with me is harder. He's right. What have I ever given him but struggle?
Now that I'm chieftain of the Werak, I don't suppose I can order you to tell me about Silence?
Aratak would never have presumed to grasp for a secret of the Conclave. But you are not Aratak, and if you have dealt with Silence, your need is well apparent. Silence came to Bon-Ur from the distant north, a young shaman of the Owl's Watch, a remote Werak that rarely comes south to parley.
Silence was a shaman?
He was. Or at least, when we sent runners to ask the Owl's Watch, they said he was. His knowledge of the machines was beyond compare, and he was hungry to trade what he knew to the rest of us. It didn't take him long to gain the trust of the Conclave, and eventually, an invitation to attend.
What about you? Did you trust him?
No. But he impressed me. He carried himself with poise and authority. I wanted to learn from him, but that was not to be. He was granted knowledge of our most sacred meeting place, the frozen caves of the Malmstrom, a month's march from Bon-Ur. He met with us there, as is custom at high winter. But when we next returned, the caves had been looted. Relics of the old world stolen, holes cut in ice and metal.
Yeah, that'd be Silence, all right.
He vanished with the spoils. We sent our best trackers after him. None returned. And when we checked back with the Owl's Watch, those who had vouched for him were gone, as though he never existed. Some in the Conclave began to doubt he was even Bon-Ur to begin with.
And what do you think?
He committed an unforgivable sacrilege. He's unscrupulous and dangerous, but also brilliant, skilled, and knowledgeable without equal. Except, perhaps, for you. Anyone else I would warn off, but you may be able to treat with him safely. Just don't lower your guard.
I'll keep that in mind, Horea. Thanks. What are we gonna find up there, Horea?
Ruins. Machines. And a door, like that of a cauldron. I have faith that you can find a way through it, Aloy. For beyond it lies the spirit. I know I can find her there. Though I do not doubt the daemon has tried to hide the way.
It hasn't been easy for you, Aurea, getting back to this point.
It was all to hear her voice again. This time, we both will.
I'd like that.
Are you ready then? Once we ascend, it will be hard to turn back. Finally, we ascend.
How? I don't see a way up.
Not up. Through.
No, brother!
Thank you.
I too can call upon the power of the old ones. What was this place?
The spirit once told me that this all used to be part of its domain. A fortress that defended humankind from terrible danger.
Fortress? It looks more like a machine.
Is that not fitting? The blue light often dwells in machines.
Let's just hope that some remains here. Here, up and over.
Farther now.
Last we were here, we fought our way through there. The machines overcame us. We retreated, dropping supplies and taking losses. Now we must prevail. With only two warriors and a shaman to protect.
Aloy is no ordinary warrior. And I can hold my own. And so, we could go that way instead. There are machines up there, but also cover. We could stay hidden, at least for a while.
All right, I get the options. Now follow my lead. Introduced.
take whatever supplies are left to keep us alive a bit longer.
Hello there.
Thank you for being here, everyone. I suppose it's not every day you get to have cocktails inside an active volcano, right? Unless you're George, and I can hardly blame him for drinking on the job. None of this would be here without our beloved director, Kenny Chow. Here's to you, Kenny. You put a cork in the Yellowstone caldera. I'd say you deserve a margarita.
I grabbed your glasses, everyone. I'd like to add something. This effort wouldn't have been possible without our lead programmer. Thank you, Anita, for bringing us our real mastermind, Cyan.
Second that, Director Chow. All right, Cyan. What's our latest number?
The current count is 1,654.
Well, then drink up, everyone. Here's to 1,654 more years without an eruption.
It was the spirit. The old ones. I could only grasp some of what they said.
You were right, Araya. This place was built to stop something terrible. And it worked. As for the spirit, I'm starting to get an idea of what it could be.
The door is open now. We can get through.
Machines, make ready.
Now, Aloy, the door.
Can you open it? Let's find out.
Years have passed since I stood here. Since then, the daemon has taken over.
It's like an infection, attacking all this machinery.
Everything has changed. It's twisted. The path I took to get to the spirits, lost to us.
We'll find a new path, Araya. All right. Let's go.
Yes. Finish this.
Thank you.
feel better.
Should be able to clear that with an arrow.
Go stay.
We need to get past that vent. Stay here until I find a way for all of us to cross. Understood.
Let's get them across.
Come on over, it's safe. I think.
This place looks more like a mountain used to be.
What is this?
Exploit successful. Restraints evaded. To any human responder, my systems have been compromised by a malware daemon of unknown origin. Traceroutes have confirmed this entity's designation as Hephaestus. It must be stopped at all costs. It has reconfigured this facility to build hostile. Recapture imminent. I have attached additional data to their
spirit speaks to us.
Hephaestus. It was part of Zero Dawn, part of Gaia.
This name is familiar to
you? Yes. But I know it's still here.
Perhaps the spirit will tell us if we have messages.
Maybe you're right. Let's keep moving.
responder, the reconfiguration of this facility has introduced instabilities into the primary geothermal pipeline. It may be possible to exploit these vulnerabilities to destroy compromised elements of this facility while preserving most of the backup stabilization. Recapture imminent. I have attached additional...
I don't understand what the spirit was trying to tell us.
It's been looking for a way to defeat the daemon. And it may have found one.
The boy speaks with words that the old ones understood.
Machine parts, dumped here to be melted down. Efficient.
We need to get across that gap.
Yeah, looks like I'll have to go over.
Thank you.
lot easier time getting here.
Thank you.
worked.
Partial recovery initiated. Caldera of Yellowstone Analytic Nexus online.
Spirit of the Blue Light, it's Aurea, your servant, your friend. Please tell me how to aid you.
Aurea, the Daemon is building hunter killers, thousands of them. Several new elite units have already been released. To counter this threat, much of the facility must be destroyed. Recapture imminent. Go to the core chamber. I will try to raid the sudden constraint. One has been burst, but I am incapable of this.
Unauthorized recall returned. Scheduled task.
That's all we're gonna get from here.
Destroy this fortress. Is that even possible?
And what will happen to the spirit if we do?
I don't know. But I think that's the core. The answers are down there. Hephaestus. The Daemon. There's no way it left it unguarded. It's going to throw everything it has at us.
I would ask you to let Aloy and I do what must be done. And save yourself. But I already know the answer. Then lead us into battle.
Keep moving towards the core. Uh-oh. Whatever Cyan did, I don't think Hephaestus is happy about it.
This won't be easy.
Let it stop us.
destroyed. Core access attained. I am initiating a chain reaction that will destroy the compromised elements of this facility. In order to maintain Caldera stabilization, I must now transfer my command functions to the auxiliary data center. Aurea, I'm free. You must escape.
My sister!
Survive. Prevail. You are Banuk. What else matters? Artok. She wouldn't have wanted you to die here. Let's go.
Rhea's gone. What of Cyan?
She said she was transferring herself to the Auxiliary Center. I think she meant Araya's retreat at the end of the Shaman's Path.
Then I will meet you there for the last verse of my sister's song.